Hi students, hi scouts.
Hi.
New scouts as well as old scouts. Okay? Here we are today. After a long time, after this difficult time of pandemic, we are here with some scout videos. Let's see if we can learn a few and revise a few knots that we had previously done. You remember, sir was there for the camp and we learned a few knots. Okay? But this is a video for your refreshment and the scouts who want to join new in our school, they will be joining new for the new scouts, new recruits rather. Okay, so we are going to revise some scouts, revise some knots. Okay, and let's go, let's do sir first the the scout sign. Okay, scout sign, this is a scout sign. Okay, the threefold promise, strong finger protecting the weak finger, and from here we have the scout salute. The sir will explain to you in short the parts of the uniform. Okay, yes sir.
Okay. Welcome boys. Okay, now a part of the uniform, we'll start with the beret first. Okay, this is called a beret. Okay, there's a badge on your left eyebrow. Okay, so whenever you wear a beret, you have to check it whether your badge is on the eyebrow or no. So either you do this or you just close the left eye and you will get your size. Then we come down, this is your scarf. Okay, each school or each scout unit is having a different color of scarves.
This is St. Xavier's, okay, Manikpur Vasai, this is their color. And
this is Anthony D'Souza School, bicolor. Okay, you can wear any color scarf except green, orange and purple.
Take a note, sir, again.
Okay, you can wear any scarf, any color scarf except green, orange and purple. These are the scarf colors for the commissioners, for the higher rank, so you cannot wear them. Okay, then we come down the plastic woggle, or this is called a woggle, which is binding the scarf together. Okay, whenever you are wearing a woggle, you have to make sure that the scout, the Bharat Scout and Guide logo, is in an upright position. Okay, you can just come closer, you can see it's in upright position. You cannot put it downwards, it should be pointing upwards.
So any other colors did you have for that?
There are various colors, but you universally we follow off-white color. Okay, then you come down, is this your scout logo? Okay, it's the round color which is on your left chest. Okay, just come below that is your scout badge, green color, on your left pocket, exactly in the center of the pocket. Okay, make sure it is in the center of the pocket. Then you come to your right side, this is your nameplate. These are only used by the scout masters and the higher rank. This is not for you all. Then this is the scout strip. Okay, India strip. Okay, and these are the state badges. Okay, so if you have done a higher this thing, or you have done your higher rank, yes, then you get an India badge. Okay, in the Maharashtra, you get a Maharashtra badge. Okay, so this is a scout uniform. The color of the shirt is grey color, a dark grey, which is universal for all in India. Okay, and a navy blue long pant.
Long or short?
Short or long, yeah.
Held like a shoe.
And a belt, the scout belt. Okay, so this is the scout uniform. So let's begin with the knots. Okay, before we begin with the knots, we will explain each knot is having a purpose. Okay, it is not just made for time pass. Okay, each knot there is a use. So before we show you the knot, we are going to tell you the use of that particular knot.
Yes.
Okay, you can also make uses of this knot in your day-to-day life. Now since you are at home in this pandemic, you can use this, practice this knot for maybe tying a rope or trying a clothesline.
Yes.
Okay, so try and make uses of these knots at home.
Always sir, the scouts are always helpful at home.
Yeah.
They're helpful to society. So the scouts have to keep this, like they have to be helpful to people around. That's the actual work of a scout.
A scout, okay? Scout.
Yes. Once a scout, always a scout. So we start with the first knot. I will...
Right. Before we start, you have to always make sure that the ends of the rope, okay,
should be like this, not like
this. Whip. Yeah. Okay, we will do this, the whipping part, in the second part of the scout's video. First, you can just put a sellotape around. We have put a orange sellotape so it is visible for you all. So this is what happens when you do not whip the rope. Okay, it opens up. And then when you're tying knots, it becomes difficult for you.
In fact, sir, it spoils the rope.
It spoils the rope. It will keep opening and ultimately it is of no use. So when you tie a sellotape or just stick it with a glue, it will hold. It will not open up. Okay, so if your ropes are open, if your ropes are open from this end, just cut it and put a sellotape. So it will not open more. Okay, make sure that your ropes are intact. So let's begin with the first knot, which is reef knot. Okay, sir will explain you the first knot.
Now reef knot is a very important knot. If you someone explain to you the batches, it's there on the scout logo. The reef knot, every scout has to know this knot. I think many of you all know it. New children will learn it. It is used to bind two ropes of the same thickness and same same kind of ropes. Okay, let's see. One right over left and left over. Right over left and left over right. Okay, so you should get a loop like this. Okay, let's try it again. Left over right and just the opposite, right over left, and you get a reef knot. Okay,
that's the equal thickness. Yes. Okay,
and now we have the second knot.
The second knot is a sheet band. Okay, now it is exactly opposite what sir showed. It is used to tie two ropes of unequal thickness. Okay, now if you just tie a normal knot to two different type sizes of knot ropes, it will open up. So there is a special knot which is called sheet band. Okay, sheet band. Normally this knot is used for the flag. When you tie a national flag on a pole, the rope which is gone through the flag is of a different thickness, and the rope which we are going to pull down is of a different thickness. So this knot is used for basically
point to be noted. Yeah,
flag time. Okay, so take a rope, just make a loop. Okay, make a loop on one end. Okay, the other end has to go from within, from the loop which you have already made. Then go around the loop. Okay, go around the loop and come back from the same loop which has been created by your rope. So let it go inside and then pull. Now this is also called as a knot of 8, a figure of 8. Can you see the figure of 8?
Figure of 8.
So
point
this
to
is
be noted.
So figure once this is done, it doesn't slip. Mm-hmm. It holds. Okay? I'll just show you once again.
You can try along as you do it.
Make a loop on one end, the other end of the rope, if you go from underneath. Okay, come out, go around the loop which you have already made and go back in the same loop which you have created by turning. So go from there. Do not go from the loop which you have created the first. Okay, catch both and pull. So whenever you are showing the knots to sir, okay, there is a system of showing. You cannot just pull and show. Okay, hold this and show. The figure of 8 has to be seen.
Figure of 8, you can note it down. Figure of 8.
Okay, so you have to hold and show your knot like this. Same for the reef knot, you have to hold both the ends and show. If you do like this, we will not understand what that knot is. So, always show it in a proper position. Okay, the next is
Borain.
Clovis.
Oh, Clovis, you show
okay.
Clovis, yes.
Yeah. So, sir will show you the Clovis. I will hold the.
Okay, Clovis. It's a hitch. Okay, it is used to tie a rope to a bamboo. Okay, now you are facing the bamboo or staff. You go around the bamboo. First loop is over the rope. Okay, you turn around and you find this loop here. You pull the rope and this is the clovis.
Just take a closer look. Okay, this knot doesn't slip. Yeah. Okay, I'm applying the pressure, but it is not slipping down. So there's a difference between a knot and a hitch.
Yeah.
A knot is used to tie two ropes, and a hitch is used. A rope is used to tie to a pole. Or fasten a pole or join two poles with the help of a rope. It is called a hitch.
It is a very important knot if you are learning lashings.
Yes.
For lashing, this is very important.
When we will go to the second part, we will learn lashing.
Yes.
The starting and the end has to be with the plovil. So this is one of the important knots in the scout. If your base, this is your base, if your base is weak, then your model will fall down.
Whatever work you are doing, are you building a tent or a
gadgets,
it will not stand.
It will not stand. So the base has to be strong, because you are going to put another bamboo on this knot. So if this is going to slip down, this the other bamboo is also going to slip down. So this is called plovil. So can you show this again?
I'll show it again. Plovil. Yeah. Okay. So you hold the bamboo for me. Yeah. Okay. So you take the rope and you first make a cross over. Don't do it under, make it over. You can forward this clip, go back and check the, okay? And then make sure it's enough long, and then you come into this gap, okay? This gap here. And then you pull the rope and you get a club hitch, okay? You should get a hitch like this. It's called a club hitch.
Okay, now the specialty of scout knots is they are easy to tie and easy to release. Now I want to release this knot, I will just, it is coming out.
So smart. Scouts are smart.
So can you hold? So it is strong. It is strong also, and it is easy to release also, and it is not moving also. So I just have to pinch and my knot is
open.
Okay.
Club hitch. That was club hitch. So next.
Club hitch. Now we will see a knot which is connected to this, which is called rolling hitch.
Rolling hitch.
It is same like club hitch, but instead of one loop, you have to take two loops. That is the only difference between rolling hitch and club hitch. Okay, I will tell you the uses also. Okay, so first, as sir told, the first round will be from top. Okay, then second round also go from top. So you got two loops, roll.
Yeah.
The third one is exactly like club hitch. So only difference what you will see in rolling hitch is you will get this two loop, one loop extra.
Two loops. And what is used for, sir?
Use is this knot is moving on one side only. Okay?
It only turns on one side.
The reason is, in the village, when they tie a bull or a cow to a pole, if this knot is fixed or if they use it a club hitch, the bull will go around, after 5 rounds he will get choked. Okay?
Smart again.
So the knot has to move with the bull so that the bull doesn't get choked with the rope. Okay? And releasing position is the same, just hold one and this is open. So this is called a rolling hitch.
Okay. Rolling hitch. Okay. Now some little bowline.
Bowline. Yeah.
Something for rescue.
Yes.
Okay, I'll take a longer rope. Okay, excuse me for that end of this rope. But this is a knot which is used for if somebody is drowning.
By the disaster people, National Disaster Management people, they use to save the people of the people who are drowning, or somebody, as you must have seen in the news, that so and so child is fallen in the well. So how to remove? If the knot is slipping knot, he might get choked. But these knots, just see how the knot is.
So I'll try the knot first for you, and then I'll put a story for it. Okay. So I'll first get the knot done for you, and then okay. Now depends on the loop. This is the loop. It can be held with the hand, sir.
Yeah.
So it will not move.
The knot will not slip.
If you make a bigger loop, it can be put around somebody's neck also. Okay. So, okay. So I'll show you how to do a small and a very funny story of the snake and the coconut tree and the well. Three characters, keep in mind. Okay, get it carefully. Okay, just get a nice big rope on your hand.
How big the loop you want, you can take that much long. Okay,
okay. You look, make a small loop outside and hold it like that. Okay, the loop should be outside,
upper loop.
And then this is a snake. This is a multi-headed snake, sorry. The snake goes up, comes out of the well, turns around the tree, and goes back into the well. Okay? You hold the snake and you pull the coconut tree, you get this bowline. Okay? So this loop is small, I made it small so that the rope is also short. But in the rescue scenario, they make it very big so that it can
whole
can
body
go around somebody. Yes, it can go around somebody.
Now also keep it important when sir is taking a test or sir is taking an exam, or when you do your higher studies in scouts, or if you are applying for some much, I explained you what is Rashtrapati Puraskar and what is
yes
Rashtriya Puraskar.
Rashtriya Puraskar.
Okay, that is state and national. If the question is asked, is there tie a bowline for a cat? Then you have to see that the loop is of a head of a cat. You cannot take a big loop. The cat will whole cat will pass through, yeah. And you will be failed. Okay. If the question is tie a bowline for a elephant, then the loop will be big, not small one. Okay, so it depends how long you want or how big you want, that much you release and take a loop, upper loop on top. So if I want a big, I will keep this snake big. I will keep the snake big. Okay, then this is your tree. Okay, now I am doing it for a dog, for example. Okay, the snake comes out of the tree, the teeth well
around, yes.
Goes around the
tree
and goes back in the well. So now this is the snake's body, this is the snake's head.
See how big loops are taken?
Catch the head and the body of the snake and pull the tree. So now at least a dog can fit in this.
So even I can fit, so let's try.
Sounds again. So this knot doesn't slip. Okay? If you put in the neck of the animal, then if the knot slips, the animal might die.
Yes.
Okay, so
for rescue.
Is, yeah.
For rescue.
Important thing is the knot should not slip.
So let's go to the next knot.
It's called Sheepshank.
Sheepshank.
Okay, the next one is sheepshank. Now sheepshank is used to shorten a rope without cutting it. Okay, so
shorten.
If I have gone for hiking and I want to use a short rope instead of a long rope, so I will not cut it. If I cut it, I will not be able to reuse it again.
Scout
is smart. Okay, use a knot, shorten it, reuse it again. Okay, if you cut, you will not be able to reuse. So I want to shorten this rope. So what I am going to do is I am going to take a loop. Okay, leave one side, go to the first end, just twist it and put this rope head in the loop which is created. Okay,
tighten it, yes,
and pull it. You have to pull it, then go to the other side, same thing, twist it and put it in the loop head which you have just created. Okay, and pull it tight. So what I have done is I have shortened the big rope into a short rope. Okay, so I will use it and then I will reopen it again for next use. So this is called a
sheep shank.
Okay. Okay.
Sheep shank. Yes.
Okay. The next knot is called fisherman knots.
Oh, fisherman.
Okay. You must have seen, or you can just open the YouTube and see. A fisherman carry a small bucket. Now this is of metal, but he use of the bamboos, which doesn't have a handle. Okay. So with this knot you can make a handle. For example, if you go for a scout camp and you have got a dirty water which you want to boil it, you cannot put this in the fire straight away because you will not be able to lift it again.
Yes.
So what I will do is I will create a handle with the help of a rope so that I can just hang it somewhere and the water is boiling. Sometimes you don't have metal, you have plastic. So if the plastic, if you put in the fire, the plastic will melt. Okay, so it is used to create a handle to a utensil or a bottle which doesn't have a handle to catch it.
Point to be noted. Okay.
Okay.
Keep this point.
Okay. So simple. Take one end of the rope and tie a knot around the rope. Not to the rope, around the rope. So same rope I am tying. Okay. And see that this end is moving. The same thing I will do with this on this end. Okay, go around and I will make a knot. Okay, now make sure that these knots are moving. Okay, same way. Then what you have to do is you have to put your rope around the neck of the vessel. Okay, and just pull it.
Scouts help each other. So smart, see that? So smart.
Okay.
And so easy.
So what I have done is, I have just basically created a
handle.
A handle. So I can just hang it somewhere and my water is boiling. or I can hang it somewhere and keep.
And it's strong, sir.
It is strong. It is not loose. Okay. So fishermen, they normally use a bamboo vessel.
Yes.
Okay, bamboo
or wooden vessel.
Yeah, wooden vessel without this, and then they hang it to their pant. Okay. So this is called a fisherman's knot.
Fisherman's knot.
Just pull it and you open it.
And you can reuse it for something else.
Okay, you can reuse it.
You can tie some bottle or something. I don't have a bottle here right now. We are in the middle of a jungle, sir.
Okay.
Jungle.
Right. Okay. The next knot we are going to see, which is the last knot for today, is called the fireman chair knot.
Fireman chair.
Fireman.
Again, the rescue knot.
Chair knot. Okay. Most of the, all the firemen should know this knot. Now, for example, I am a fireman or I am a scout, and I have encounter a certain situation where a person is stuck on the fifth floor or first or second floor and who is unconscious, who cannot catch the rope.
Yes.
If a person can catch a rope, I can easily make the
bowline
and he can hold and come down.
Bowline is a better option.
Okay. This is when the person is unconscious or who cannot walk or you cannot hold. Okay. So this knot will help him to come down. Okay. Without his support. Okay. What you have to do is make two loops. One is outer loop, okay, outer loop, and one is inside loop. Okay, if I show you from side, you can make out. Okay,
outer loop and inner
outer loop and inner loop, and you have to just intersect these two loops holes and catch their inside this thing. Then this will the down will increase the size of the loop. How big is the person, and the top will fix the size. So once this is done, you put your hands in this, legs in this, and then the person can be lowered down from the floor.
Yes. Smart, right?
Okay.
We can't do a big one with this rope. It's a practice rope.
We will show this knot with the help of a picture also.
Yes.
Okay. So we'll stick a picture in the video.
We'll see a picture,
and so we'll show you. I'll just show this knot again.
Watch again.
This is one of the important knots.
Yeah, like we have seen a lot of disasters happening around us. Fine. If you know this knot well, you can help out.
Two loops. Inside loop and outside loop. Okay. You can see. Okay. If you take both the same side, then it will not work. Okay. So one has to be opposite.
Opposite. Yeah.
Okay. Then you have to just simply intersect. Okay, intersect.
Cross the mixture.
Okay, from this loop I will pull this one, and from this loop I will pull this loop. And I will increase the size, and once I get a desired size, I will pull the top to fix the size. So this is a fireman's chair knot. Because once a person is fixed in this, it is seen as if he's sitting in the chair.
Yeah, it can be his hand body can go here. The feet can go. I'll put a picture.
Okay, so we'll put a picture and then it will get clear for you. Okay, so practice these knots at home and see. Okay.
So for today, sir, let's go and enjoy the beautiful forest.
Beautiful forest.
Yeah, we'll visit the forest. We'll see you in the next video whenever.
Next part. With lashings and knots, the remaining knots.
So we both would like to wish you safe, stay at home. Don't move out of the house unnecessarily. Keep safe. Protect yourself. Be useful.
And keep practicing the knots.
Yes.
Right?
And a scout is always a person who is always prepared.
Helpful and prepared.
Helpful and prepared. So once a scout, always a scout. So see you all. Bye bye.
See you all. Bye bye. See you next time.
So we enjoy the season.